Hello. Thank you.
You don't know nothing about me. I don't know nothing about you now. I thought it would never be us, another flame into dust now. And maybe you took a mistake. Why, why, yeah. To see you were always this way.
Thank you guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Directors Guild of Canada, Tim Southam.
Thank you, Amal. Thank you for that performance, and thank you for coming back to Toronto just for us. This is a new aspect ratio. I think it's Turno vision. It's a turn right here vision. It's not virtual reality. I have to actually do things. Welcome everyone to the 18th annual Directors Guild of Canada Awards. I want to kick off this evening of thank yous with a huge shout out to the wonderful team at the Guild who put this entire evening together. Thank you so much, Team DGC. And I want to thank RT for lending us his talents as this year's creative director. And now they can come and get you and bring you backstage to do something. I don't know what it is.
Nous nous retrouvons une fois de plus dans une période de transformation inédite pour notre industrie et pour la planète.
We seem to say it every year. It's a time of staggering technological, cinematic, planetary, political, and social shifts. We know this. As I stand here, though, I can't help rejoicing this week that Canada does seem to have a robust democracy full of demanding, decent, wise, generous citizens who have become very good at getting our message out. I don't know, we may have stumbled into being the best in the world at this point. And before I leave, I wanted to say that I figured out what makes art so special. Dans ce monde tellement bousculé, qu'est-ce qui nous rend nous, les artistes, si indispensables? Well, here's one idea. What makes art so special is that it doesn't generalize. Institutions generalize. Businesses, governments, NGOs, guilds generalize. Good people generalize. Mean people generalize. But, and here I admit I'm generalizing, art, at its best, doesn't. It deals in the specific, the personal, the intimate. The works we're celebrating tonight dive deep into the individual experience. They invite us to identify, to empathize, to slip our own skins long enough to see others and ourselves in a new light. From the particular comes the general, and this is what I am certain will help us keep getting better at building wiser and kinder communities. Ce soir, nous saluons les œuvres d'artistes disparus. Nous rendons hommage aux artistes émergents. We celebrate creators at the height of their craft. Each is a unique voice, and each has opened a window for the rest of us into some specific, but also boundless aspect of who we are. I'm honored to honor their work with you tonight. Bonne soirée à tous. Have a great party.
What you did was impulsive, capricious, and melodramatic. But it was also wrong.
Kids, say hi to your mother.
Hey.
She's not my mother.
Who are those voices?
Your children?
Hello.
Now welcome to the stage, star of the CBC hit show, Mr. D, and your fellow DGC member, Jerry D.
Hello. Is this supposed to stay? Is that for decoration? Okay, kind of in the way, but I'm a director. Not really, but I'm a DGC member, $187.50 every quarter, I'm reminded. Can I move this, anybody? Is this, or is that part of the set? I don't know if the, is that, it doesn't move, okay. So we could have, maybe we could have just made it work and I'd have one mic, but so I'll come out here. I have 9 minutes left, can't wait. No, I'm kidding, I'm doing an hour. So, I don't know how you do it. First of all, I want to congratulate Mars and Dean and Maria from our show who are being nominated. Yeah. They're the only three I care about in the room right now, to be honest. No, I care about all of you. Probably not going to win, guys, because we haven't won in 8 years, so don't get too excited over there. But you get a nice meal. I don't know how you do it. You have a... the DGC, which is, you know, it's a lot of people are involved in a show. Accountants, where are they at? Yes, that's when they're included. I don't know if I agree with that, but you're in an office and you sign checks. And I say we, I'm not gonna lie, I don't feel like I belong as a DGC member. Let's talk about the elephant in the room, actors who direct. Why is that a thing? I don't know. I don't know if that's right. I did it. It was sixth season of our show, and they're like, do you want to direct? I'm like, I guess. I probably should, because I see everyone else do it that acts. And I did all that stuff. I watched. I did that. Why don't we start here? I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm like, we'll start here. Come up top. I'm like, we don't have a jib. Okay. Well, we won't come up top then. Relax, first AD. Why are you always so angry? I know, because the accountants call you and say, don't go over. That's why. I know how you deal with actors, directors I'm talking to, even editors. Thank God that we're not allowed in the room with the editors. Can you imagine? It's bad enough we're in the room with the directors. I don't know how you can avoid that part, but I don't know how you do it. We are, man. My trailer had a sink. I had a sink in my trailer. I don't know. Why are you treating us so well? I blame you for treating us too well as actors, and then that's where the problem starts. I had a sink. I don't need a sink. You know what actors want? A mirror, because we like to look at ourselves and talk to ourselves and practice the one line we have over 3 days. We want to get it right. 187.50. Sometimes I forget. They're like, hey, you're late. You could relinquish your membership. Who'd care? Who would any of you care if you're like, oh my God, Jerry D's not a member of the DGC anymore? What the hell? Who's going to direct all our great shows? It's hard. I have notes here because I can't remember all this, but I wrote this specifically for the night. Also not a writer, but I'm in the WGC. I am an actor, and I get, you know what? Why do we direct? Why do actors say, my turn? No, it's not. You didn't study this. You watched real directors, and now you're, thank God for the camera operators and the DOPs, because I would purposely walk into a scene late, because then they had the shot set up. I'm like, perfect. Perfect. This is great. They're like, do you want to start here? I'm like, yeah, come in here. Come around. Good. Two shot. Just say two shot. What size lens do you want? 45, 270? I don't know. That's the clue you don't know what you're talking about. I don't know. 45, 250. Want to do slow-mo? I don't know how to do slow-mo. Can't do it. Might cross the axis. Still don't know what that means, by the way. How the hell can you be a director and you don't know what crossing the axis means? They would talk. They would call me over. Jerry, I don't know. You think we're crossing the axis here? I'm like, oh, yeah, geez. Let's see. I have no freaking clue what I'm talking about. Yeah, okay. Well, if we're on that side for that, I don't know. You guys decide. You guys decide. I'm not here to spoon feed you. I'm the director. You figure that out. You don't see directors third season go, yeah, I've been watching the actors. I'd like to act a little bit now. You don't see that. You'd never hear that. You'd never get a director at the producer's office going, yeah, I've been watching a lot. I think I can do this. Oh, really? Okay, well, why don't you act in a couple of sitcoms, maybe a couple of dramas that you've been watching? Sure. Did you go to school for this? No, I can do it, though. Just... I'm in here. Don't cross the axis. I'm good. So I apologize. I'll be honest. First thing I did when I was offered a chance to direct, called my directors. I did. I called my directors. I said, look, I don't know, Mike, am I supposed to do this? Like, I feel like I'm taking work away from you. And I was. He goes, yeah, you are. I'm like, oh. He goes, but no, it's okay. It wasn't a vote of confidence. He's like, it's okay. I won't work this month. I'm like, oh, Well, why don't you take some acting classes? Maybe I can get you in a couple of the episodes. I really do admire, I say fellow DGC. I don't know if I might stop paying just because it just feels wrong. I'm never directing again, let's be honest. No one's out there going, is Jerry D available? See if he's available. He directed two episodes. He directed two episodes in eight seasons. He must be good. So yeah, I kind of apologize if I took work away from a director, but just know that the work suffered. Makes you feel better. I don't know how we, the thing I didn't understand about being a director was, I'm in the scene. How the hell am I supposed to watch the scene when I'm in? It's just simple logic. I don't know if there's a boom. There are three boom mics in my shots. Because I didn't, just an empty chair. I'm running around. Okay, let me see. All right, that looks good. No idea if it looks good, but got to move on here because the AD's shitting on me every 5 seconds. Got to go. We got to go. I was a teacher for 10 years. I think that DGC members, very similar to a school environment, right? Directors to me are the principal. That's the principal of the set. The directors, just like a school. They're in charge, right? They like to think that, but it's good to say it because there are a lot of them here tonight. But they are in charge. They are, especially in film. Ooh, I learned. That's different. I might direct a couple films. I don't know. I'm still deciding. I'm like, no action shots. Then you got the ADs and the support staff. They're like the vice principals. Very similar, right? They answer to the principal. They're the ones that have to deal with all the discipline, the actor. Who are the students? Actors are the students who also think they're the principal. It's a little different. It's a little different sometimes. But I'm not going to talk a lot. Let's see if I'm pretty good. I didn't look at this once as a writer. It's kind of how I did my lines. Be like, huh, yeah, that's pretty good. I got it all in here. Holy cow, that's amazing. I said, do you have any like small pieces of paper I can have on stage just to kind of discreetly look at my notes? Yeah, here you go. Here's a whole friggin'. Can I get a second mic that just blocks me from moving? But listen, and in all seriousness, I had a great time on our show. I had a great run. Mike Volpe, my co-creator and partner on the show, is over there. And it's just, he directed as well. I don't know what's worse, a producer directing or an actor directing. Yeah, I think I just got my answer. We're really appreciative of all the work that all of you do, and I can't tell you how much that the support from the people like yourselves, the editors, the accountants, the everybody, the ADs, the producers, that the assistant directors, I mean, not the producers. We're not here to talk about them. Right? They do nothing. Just show up and bug you. No, I was a producer, too. I was a producer, writer, director. I didn't know anything to do with any of those three jobs. But I wish you luck tonight. I know some of you, this is a big deal. It's not. Just want to let you know that. Okay? Some of you are texting your parents, like your family, we're next. Oh, my God, I'm so nervous. No one cares later. The people that care are you. That's it. Your family doesn't care. Go home tonight, the winners, and go, I won. Who cares? Nobody cares in the family. So maybe that helps you relax a little tonight. Nobody cares but you. And if you care too much, stop. Stop. Because it's not that big a deal, right? It's like we voted, and did you have to vote, right, for each other? And you vote, you submitted. The irony of that to me in these awards, people act surprised. Oh, my God, I'm nominated. Oh, wow. Yeah, you asked to be nominated. Don't act surprised. So let's not make a big deal of this tonight, because it's not. Let's just remember that when you get it. Do not cry on stage. That is the worst. You're just, You let yourself go. If I see anyone crying on stage because you won, stop. It's too much. It's too much. Okay? Just thank you. It's great. It's a nice trophy. I'm saying this because I've never won. You realize that. I've never won. I've sat there, like all of you, anxiously awaiting, thinking this is the year, and it's not. So I'm sorry, Mars. I'm sorry. No, I think our team's winning something tonight. Now, if we don't, Mars, if you do, don't cry, please, because I just said that. But enjoy yourself. In all seriousness, getting nominated is a win, right? We say that to ourselves. It's like a win. It's bullshit, but we say it. It's like a win. It's like, I already won. It's already won. No, you don't. You hope you win. So let's get two things before I go. It's not a big deal if you win, and nomination is not like a win, okay? Good luck, everybody. Thanks for letting me come up tonight. And thank you to everybody at the DGC. You guys are a big part of every show and every film. Thank you so much.
Please join me in welcoming to the stage our creative director for the evening, your own RT.
For the record, we're all winners, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Raptors massive. Raptors in the building. All right. So tonight we celebrate the experience and the craft that has built this community, our community, into what it is today. That's the legacy, as the people that came before us, the people who laid the groundwork, and then the bold new voices that helped to take us into that brave new world that Tim spoke of a moment ago, AKA the next generation, the next gen. The nominated work today, tonight, reflects that mix. We've put together a great show, and we hope that you guys enjoy it. It's gonna reflect that too. I had to bring out a couple of filmmakers that represent the next gen to help me kick off the show. My friends, Niney, who just wrapped her debut, This Place, feature debut, coming soon. And of course, Young Jazz, who's nominated tonight for her debut feature, Firecrackers. Big up. Stay tuned, you're gonna be hearing a lot more from them in the next little while.
Thanks, RT. Hey, you have a show coming out, don't you?
Yeah, I do. It's just a sci-fi hip-hop show. It's like another one of those. Like, don't matter about that.
Come on, RT. You have to break new ground, right?
True.
And like tonight, we're breaking new ground because we have three new categories that allow us to honor more of our picture editors, our sound editors, and our production designers. And don't they deserve it?
Yeah.
So let's start and get to the first award of the night. The nominees for Best Sound Editing, Comedy, or Family Series are P. Jason McNeil, John Smith, James Robinson, Odd Squad, World Turned Odd.
Odd Squad!
Kevin Howard, Robert Hegedus, Kevin Banks, Richard Calliston, P. Jason McNeil, Heartland, Episode 1207, Running Scared. Janice Earley, Mark Shinersky, Kaylee Melito, Clive Turner, Alistair Gray, Susan Fawcett, Gren Eric, Charles Zwicker, Simon Miminis, Northern Rescue, Episode 109, Wake Up. Christopher Allen King, Susan Conley, Taylor Brocklesby, Little Dog, Episode 201, Round 8. Alan Fung, Gray Allader, Melissa Hinton, Holly Greenlee, Holly Hobby, Episode 101, The Showstarter.
And the winners are Janice, Mark, Kaylee, Clive, Alistair, Susan, Gren, Simon, Northern Rescue, Episode 109. Wake up!
Finally, bridesmaids no more. congratulations to all nominees tonight. This is really quite a surprise, and we're very happy and proud for it. I'd like to thank our amazing team at JAM, some extraordinary people to work with, and just a really great family to be a part of every day. And my partner in crime, Mark, who isn't here tonight, thanks to him. My husband and family, and to Don Carmody and David Cormican. Thank you so much.
And now the nominees for Best Picture Editing, Comedy, or Family Series. Drew McLeod, Letterkenny, episode 501, We Don't Fight at Weddings. John Nichols, Little Dog, episode 201, round 8. Michelle Semberg, Northern Rescue, episode 101, Que Sera. Maria Sahila and Dean Soltis, Mr. D, episode 803, Breaking Slime. And Richard Schwandel, Louder Milk, episode 206, Our Lips Are Sealed.
And the winner is... Michelle Semberg, Northern Rescue, Que Sera.
I'd like to first thank Don Carmody and David Cormican for giving me this amazing experience. It was challenging and very rewarding, and now we can celebrate with this. I'd like to thank the directors I worked with, Bradley Walsh, for this episode that we did together, Gail Harvey, Mike McGowan, my assistants, Craig Scorgi, who's amazing, who helped us sort of run the show, Phil Stillman, Deluxe, Jam Post, all the people involved, and this episode is really special to me because I found out I was pregnant while I was cutting this, so, yeah. And I did my first and second trimester on this series, and so, yeah, I want to dedicate this to my little baby who's 6 months old now, and my partner, so thank you.
Okay, and finally, well, not finally for the show, just finally for me. The nominees for Best Production Design, Comedy and Family Series. We got Brendan Smith, Schitt's Creek, episode 514, Life's a Cabaret. Oh, man.
You can do it. You can do it.
I could do this, right?
You got this. You got
okay.
This.
Zoe Saka. Cara Lupo.
No.
Nah, I messed it up. I apologize, Zoe. I've been practicing all night. The bold type. Stride of Pride. Please give us some applause. Lisa Soper, The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, Chapter 17, The Missionaries. My guy, Stephen Stanley. Holly Hobby, The Show Starter.
Lisa Soper, The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, Chapter 17.
Oh, well, thank you, everybody. I guess, first of all, I'd like to thank our Dark Lord, Roberto,
who without his incredibly passionate words and openness to creativity, I wouldn't have been able to create the incredible world that we have for The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina. And following that, I have to, of course, I want to thank the entire crew, because without every single person, and when I mean every person, I mean there's a PA that's going rolling up carpet one day that says something that's inspiring that we put into the show. And I really can't talk about all of it because I'd be here for way too long. Just off the top, Rob Seidenglanz, of course, my mentor right now, who's also given me my first directorial debut for The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, which I'm starting, I have tech survey on Monday, which is going to be great. But this was a fantastic episode, and I'm so happy and proud to be part of this family. I'm proud to be part of the DGC. And I also wanted to do a shout out for my agents at Greenlight for putting up with all of my crying when I'm having a rough day. Thank you guys so much.
Now join me in welcoming from Canada's newest side-splitting sketch comedy show, Franco Nguyen of Tall Boys, and from the upcoming Netflix original series, Tiny Pretty Things, Jesse Salguero.
Jesse, that's good. Yeah. I did not know you were gonna do that. Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
So this is kind of weird. They have me presenting Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Family series, and you for comedy, but I play a homewrecking nanny on TV. So I just think maybe we need to switch this up.
What yeah. Think? Well, the thing is, in my culture, when you go into comedy, you get disowned from your family.
Fair enough. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Nominees for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Family series are Bradley Walsh, Northern Rescue, Que Sera. Rachel Talele, The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, Chapter 6, An Exorcism in Greendale. J.J. Johnson, Odd Squad, Odds and Ends. And Gail Harvey for Northern Rescue, D-U-A-L-I-T-Y.
And the winner is Rachel Talele, The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, Chapter 6, An Exorcism in Greendale.
Unfortunately, Rachel's not with us.
She's alive. She's
not, sorry, I worded that.
She's not, she's not here. Way.
Thank you. But we're going to accept it on behalf of her. Yeah. Or someone behind us will accept it on behalf of her.
We'll give it a good home. Yeah. We love you, Rachel. She has a hotel upstairs. All right. And now, the nominees for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Comedy Series. Jordan Canning and Jeremy Lalonde. Baroness Von Sketch. Is that you, Karen? Sherry White, Little Dog, Round 8. Philip Sternberg, Working Moms, Daddy's Home. Mars Horodisky, Mr. D, Episode 803, Breaking Sly.
And the winners are
doof, 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 whoosh.
Jordan Canning and Jeremy Lalonde, Baroness Von Sketch Show.
The award for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Comedy Series is presented by Sim and accompanied by a camera equipment credit of $20,000.
Hi, thank you so much. This is great. I'm not going to stand right in front of this because it'll block my face. So
right?
I'll knock to the side.
Do the side profile, people.
So thank you so much. to our amazing crew. The writers and the editors on this show work so hard. The Baroness is a wild ride to make this show, but it is such a gratifying one. And
it's like making eight short films a day some days.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So I want to thank, personally, I want to thank Aurora and Jen and Meredith and Carolyn, who are the powerhouse, brilliant women behind this show. Mm. We're also grateful that they created this and we all get to work on it. And me personally, I want to thank my cool agents who are here and my sweet man, Adam. And over to you.
I got to first thank my wife because I always forget. Even though she's not here, she'll find out that I did not thank her. So thank you, Emily. And I want to thank the DGC for hosting such an event that does not matter.
I care.
Jerry, I care.
I care.
It's nice. The food was lovely. We want to thank the CBC, who, like, let's be honest, their comedy slate is insane. You know? Comedy in Canada, you know. Let's be honest, comedy also often gets treated like second-class citizens. But our country's doing it right.
Not here.
Not here.
First class.
We're doing it well. So yeah. Thank you for that. And thank you also to Frantic Films for creating such a great show with the Baronesses and giving us jobs.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Please welcome director of the CSA-nominated documentary, The Market, and her new feature film, Honeybee, Rama Rowe, alongside Peabody Award-winning documentary filmmaker, Tiffany Shung.
The nominees for Best Short Film include a project from an established actor directing for the first time.
A film from the artistic director of one of Canada's top theatre companies.
And a film from a DGC Award-nominated production designer, nominated for a feature film tonight, also nominated for directing her first short.
These films include a documentary short captured in the mountains of Tibet, and the adaptation of a true story about a woman who refuses to rely on a system that has failed sexual assault victims and instead takes justice into her own hands.
These films may be short, but they represent the limitless range of storytelling to which so many of us directors aspire to, doc, fiction, every genre, and every style.
The nominees for the best short film are Caitlin Sponheimer, Kitty's Naughty Knickers, Martin Buzora, The Story of Pima, Katrina Saville, I Beat Up My Rapist, Wayne Manjisha, With Me, Tia Holatz, Hot Flash.
And the winner is?
Katrina Saville.
I Beat Up My Rapist.
We applied for a bunch of funding and we never got it, so I basically paid for this myself. Cost thousands and thousands of dollars. This was a story I read online, written by a young woman from Rochester, based on her own experiences. And there was just something about it that I could see it on the screen, and so I contacted her and asked her if I could adapt it, and she was very gracious in letting me tell her story. So I'd like to thank Leaf, this is for her. I'd really like to thank my producer, Gurjeet, who was, you know, let me manifest this, and Abigail Winter, she's here. She was a star. Thank you for being so vulnerable with this. I know it wasn't an easy role to take on. And to my entire cast and crew, it's, you know, short filmmaking, it's kind of where it's at because I think you do it truly for the love of filmmaking. There's no other reason to do it. It's so hard. anyways, thank you guys. Thanks.
And that brings us to our documentary awards. Let's keep rolling.
All right, the best picture editing for documentary, the nominees are Nick Hector, Prey. Trevor Ambrose, Killing Patient Zero. Eamon O'Connor, Daniel Rohr, Once Were Brothers, Robbie Robertson, and The Band. Jeff Warren, Assholes, A Theory. Shelley Theron, Queering the Script.
And the winner is
Shelley Theron,
Queering the Script.
Okay, wow. This is insane. I'm really, really very grateful to the DGC. I just really want to thank Gabrielle Zilka, my amazing director. She taught me a lot. Steph Walkney, my producer, everyone at Shaftesbury for taking a chance on me. I'm just really honored that a film about this topic is being recognized. I think it's very important that not only we have more diverse LGBT representation on screen, but also behind the screen. And I see a lot changing in this industry in terms of more LGBT folks, women, people of color, just diversity all across the board, and I want to continue to see that change. And also want to thank... just want to thank my wonderful fiance, Deborah, for supporting me through working on this film. Thanks.
And now, the Alan King Award for Excellence in Documentary, the only Guild Award accompanied by a cash prize.
Because they figured doc directors, we could use the money, right?
And they were right. The nominees are Matt Gallagher, Prey. Jennifer Birchwell, Nicholas DuPontier, Edward Burtinsky. Anthropocene, The Human Epoch. Laurie Lind, Killing Patient Zero. Igor Derlicha, The Stone Speakers. John Houston Atautsikut, Leaving None Behind.
And the winner is...
Jennifer Bishwell, Nicholas Avanti, Edward Brzezinski, Anthropocene.
The Alan King Award for Excellence in Documentary is presented by Rogers and accompanied by a cash prize of $5,000.
I didn't know there was a cash prize. Nick says he's not going to speak, and you can all force him to talk if don't. We're so grateful to be part of this community, especially as documentarians, because it's a different model, right? And we travel all over the place, and we're often working alone, sometimes with big crews and Ed, and we're all there with the drones and everything, and sometimes it's just Nick and me with the camera. And We're grateful to be part of this. We're grateful to be nominated with these other incredible films. And we're especially grateful because the message of this film and this whole project has kind of resonated in a good way with people. This is a hard subject, and we all have to talk about it. And the more ways we can figure out to talk about it, the better. This is one way. So, thank you.
The DGC Awards Gala stands for community and family. The night brings us together to celebrate each other and our work. But this is also a time to remember those members of our family who are no longer with us. Let's take a few minutes to reflect on our colleagues who have left us this past year. To introduce our nominees for post-production, movies for television and miniseries, please welcome to the stage 6-time DGC Award winner and Oscar nominee, Nelson Ferreira, and from the Hulu original series Utopia Falls, Hus Madavi.
So, 6 DGC Awards and an Oscar nomination for sound editing, huh? Geez, do you think maybe why don't you do the sound editing awards and I'll do picture editing?
So
you
can okay.
Do that? Right?
You got
good.
It.
Great.
Okay. So the nominees for best sound editing movies for television and miniseries are Brian Eimer, Michael Benigni, believe me, The Abduction of Lisa McVeigh, David McCallum, Jane Tattersall, Barry Gilmore, Claire Dobson, Paul Gurman, Christopher King for Cardinal. By the time you read this, Sam. Alan Fung, Jeffrey Raffin, Melissa Hinton, Holly Greenlee for Crossword Mysteries, A Puzzle to Die For. Gene Bott, Sue Connolly, Paul Gurman for Mary Kills People, The Key to Faith.
And the winners are David McCallum, Jane Tattersall, Barry Gilmore, Claire Dobson, Paul German, and Christopher Kim, King Cardinal, by the time you read this, Sam.
here, despite the fact that we were, the idea was, the evening was like not really that, you know. But it's a pleasure to be here, a pleasure to represent Cardinal. It's a wonderful show to work on. It's wonderful because of Sienna Films, Jennifer Kawaja and Julia Serrini, who actually, they bleed for every episode. It's so hard on them what they do. To the DGC for celebrating this whole evening. To Tom Hastings, who is a real champion of Cardinal especially. To our wonderful sound mixing team, Martin Lee and Stacey Coots. And there's people I'm forgetting. David will remember everybody.
Adam Roberts, post-production supervisor, DGC member. And our picture editors, Matt and Hugh, was very much appreciated too.
Thank you.
And now the nominees for Best Picture Editing, Movies for Television, and Miniseries. Wait a second, you don't have any awards for picture editing, do you?
No.
Great, good, good, good. Okay, good. The nominees are Hugh Elchuk, Cardinal, By the Time You Read This, Roman and Irina, Stephen Rock, Mary Kills People, Wolf Meet Hen House, Jean Coulomb, Mary Kills People, Switzerland Has Trees, Lisa Grudenbauer, Believe Me, The Abduction of Lisa McVeigh.
And the winner is... Hugh Elchuk, Cardinal, By the Time You Read This.
As Jane just said, I'd like to thank Jennifer and Julia, everyone at Sienna. They're absolutely amazing. Daniel Grew for directing such an amazing episode. Tom Hastings, everyone at CTV, and my beautiful wife, Lisa. Thank you very much. All right, have a great night.
Please allow me to welcome to the stage last year's DGC Award winner for Fargo, production designer Elizabeth Williams, and this year's CSA Award winner from Mary Kills People, Karen Robinson.
Behind the scenes? We're better behind the scenes. Okay, Karen. I see they have us presenting two categories tonight, both where Mary Kills People is nominated.
Yeah, and if Mary Kills People doesn't win at least one, someone here is going to get a very strongly worded letter. My turn. Okay, the nominees. For Best Production Design, Movies for Television, and Miniseries are, brief pause, Rory Chain, Cardinal, By the Time You Read This, Sam, Helen Kotsonis, Believe Me, The Abduction of Lisa McVeigh, Tim Bider, Mary Kills People, Switzerland Has Trees, Joe Bacot, Mad Mom.
Oh, and the winner is, hold on. Rory Cheyenne, Cardinal, By the Time You Read This.
Okay, so it looks like Rory can't be with us tonight. So, I'm sorry?
Oh, Rory's in Ireland.
All right, well, good
some people get
it. I know. Okay, well, I'll accept this on Rory's behalf. Okay, that's you.
All right, one down, one to go.
The nominees for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Movies for Television and Miniseries are...
Brief pause.
Norma Bailey, Mary Kills People, The Key to Faith.
Jem Gerard, Killer High.
Gail Harvey, No One Would Tell.
Robert C. Cooper, Unspeakable Emergence.
And Philippe Gagnon, Mean Queen. And the winner is... Norma Bailey, Mary Kills People.
The award for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Movies for Television and Miniseries is presented by Deluxe and accompanied by a service credit of $10,000.
Thank you so much. I want to first thank the Directors Guild of Canada for this annual event, which celebrates us all and brings us together across the country, which is only happens once a year. So thank you for that. I want to say that I love directing this show. I love the concept of this show. I love everyone who created this show, especially the Cameron sisters, Amy and Tassie, who continue to fight for making Canadian drama, and I don't know how they do it. Also, thank you to Chorus and E1 Entertainment, Tekka Crosby and Susan Alexander for supporting them in their endeavors. I want to thank an incredible cast, Caroline and Jay and Robert. Thanks to my DP, Michael Marshall, who I worked with so many years ago in Winnipeg and who's now one of the most incredible DOPs in the country. To Tim Bider, my production designer. And lastly, my wonderful, wonderful editor, Rosalind Callow. Thank you so much.
Please welcome seven-time DGC Award winner and past president of the Directors Guild of Canada, Sturla Gunnarsson.
Hi. Where is he? There. It's my great honor to introduce this year's DGC Lifetime Achievement Award winner, George Mihalka. George was born in Hungary, which goes a long way toward explaining his chivalry, dark humor, and abiding suspicion of authority. He was four when his parents fled the Hungarian Revolution, leaving George and his sister behind with their grandparents in Budapest. He was reunited with them 5 years later in Montreal, where they had settled as refugees. As George tells it, it was a tough transition from the urbane sophistication of central Budapest to the drab concrete housing projects at Saint Laurent and Ontario Street. He didn't speak a word of French or English, and when he began school in Montreal, he'd get into fights almost daily with English kids who thought he was French and French kids who thought he was English. So he became fluent in both official languages and learned how to fight, which turned out to be good training for our life in the Canadian screen trade. George discovered cinema at Concordia and burst onto the Montreal film scene like a Magyar horseman. While the rest of us were navigating the polite world of CanCon, George embraced genre filmmaking with a passion. One of his first films was My Bloody Valentine for Paramount Pictures. A tour de force of blood, gore, and severed organs, It was loved by fans of the genre and praised for its cinematic exuberance by its critics. And as with the work that would follow, he made a virtue of the commercial B-movie as a form of expression, embedding his creative vision and politics into the genre. My Bloody Valentine endures to this day as a cult classic. Reflecting on the film, Rue Morgue editor David Alexander says, "There's a good reason Quentin Tarantino cites it as his favorite slasher. Not only is it tense, terrifying, and totally unique, it's crafted by a filmmaker who understands that no matter how much blood you spill, no matter how spooky the setting, and no matter how iconic your boogeyman, you can't create a classic without a well-crafted story full of endearing characters." Tellingly, George describes the film as a love story set against the backdrop of an unemployed mining community. In his prolific 40-year career, George has directed over 100 productions in both French and English, among them some of the highest grossing films in top-rated television in Canadian history. He's done horror, he's done comedy, action, sci-fi, drama, all of them crafted by a filmmaker who respects the language of cinema, wields the camera like a hammer, and as one of his friends recently said, is drawn to profanity like a bauble. Achieving a body of work like this on the barren Canadian cultural landscape is an achievement indeed. And he did it in a hybrid linguistic world, bridging the two solitudes through the language of film. His first French language film was a raunchy political satire inspired by rumors of Quebec civil servants making blue movies in their legislature. Ripped from the headlines and made in less than a year, Scandale managed to both outrage the political commentariat in post-referendum Quebec and hit the box office sweet spot. Speaking about the experience, producer Robert Lantosh says, "George belongs to an exotic and highly endangered species called Can-Do. His filmography is longer than my arm." The highlights: 19 episodes of Scoop, Quebec's highest rated drama at the time, 12 episodes of Omerta, which topped Scoop as the highest rated drama, Golden Reel Award winner La Florida, Bullet to Beijing with Michael Caine, during which he fell off a ladder, broke his back, and continued directing in a wheelchair, The Hunger with Tony Scott, Terrence Stamp, and David Bowie, Da Vinci's Inquest, Lost Girl, The Firm, 24-Hour Rental, circling around back to Hungary, where he's now directing Legend of the Raven, an historical miniseries which he describes as Hungary's Game of Thrones without the dragons. And he's directing it in his native tongue. A Pier 21 immigrant, George is a love of Canada and its messy democratic institutions. He's been a vital member of the Directors Guild for over 20 years, because he sees it as a necessary organization for the artistic and material well-being of Canadian filmmakers. He chaired the Quebec District Council and kept it alive for 12 years at a time when the Guild was a lonely voice in the sovereigntist Quebec landscape. He sat on the National Executive Board as vice president for another 6 years, during which time he championed the rights of directors within the organization and helped create the National Directors Division. He's been a trusted advisor to the past three Guild presidents, myself included, and a respected member of the Guild Brain Trust, who can be counted on to court excellence and reject any form of elitism. A citizen filmmaker with a big, sprawling, glorious body of work, full of contradictions, characterized by excess, irreverence, profanity, and a love of cinema, bound together and made whole by a master craftsman with a singular voice. Let's have a look at a scene from La Florida.
Okay, vous vous souhaitez la bienvenue à Snowbird Fest, here to welcome you at Snowbird Fest. L'une de nos plus grandes vedettes, one of our great, great, great stars, le flamboyant, the inflammable, Romeo the Flame, La Flamme! Now to officiate our opening ceremonies, je vous le présente, here he is, our chevalier d'honneur en personne, the owner, le propriétaire of the Du Motel Ginette, Monsieur, Mr. Léo L'Espérance. Léo L'Espérance, Léo.
J'aurais bien voulu te voir à ma place, toi. Travailler une nuit comme chauffeur d'autobus. Passer mes fins de semaine à dépacter des caisses chez Steinberg. T'es jamais à la maison, jamais. Je manquais les fêtes des enfants, les anniversaires de mariage. Noël, hein. Il manquait Noël à une année. Gratte, puis épargne, puis mange de la vache enragée, puis du bœuf à spring. Puis où c'est que ça m'a conduit, tout ça? Dans la marde. Dans la crise de marde. Notre père qui est au Québec. Je promets de toujours avoir l'air gai, de sourire à toute personne que je rencontrerai. Hey, c'est le credo des hosties d'optimisme. C'est comme mon Jude. Tu m'excuseras de laisser tomber le sein, mais on se connaît. Quand je pense que j'ai perdu 20 ans de ma vie. Ouais. Ça va mal à la chope. T'es en train de revirer une brosse avec le patron des causes désespérées. C'est quoi ton feeling par rapport à ça, toi? Ben, ça répond à ma question. Mon maudit désespéré, toi. Tu vas t'étouffer avec ton auréole. Ah oui. Choisis ta fenêtre, mon homme. Bon voyage.
Toilet paper, not in a bucket night, Tom. Now, will you go swimming or something? Go to the Snowboard Fest. Get out of here. Do something.
Jay, you can't say that.
Sid, no water in five. Go. Go, go.
Okay.
Liam, je suis venu régler mes comptes avec toi, mon nasty. Hey, je t'ai reçu chez nous, toi. Je t'ai reçu chez nous. Tu faisais quasiment partie de la famille. Ma famille. Leo, what are you doing?
Nothing personal, Jay.
Do not point that at me. Put it away, Leo.
How do you say that in Hollywood, Florida? Huh? How do you say that?
What?
Motel owner goes berserk. Slays developer in cold blood. That's how you say
yes,
that?
Yes, yes, no, yes, Leo. This isn't like you, Leo. There's always room to negotiate, okay?
Yeah? Right. Okay. We're going to negotiate.
Okay, okay.
On va négocier, mon Chris. On va négocier comme les Américains.
Leo, we have capital punishment in Florida. You will go to the electric chair. You'll fry, Leo.
Papa! Papa! Toi, t'es Chris. Je suis plus ton père, as-tu compris? Je suis plus ton père.
Get out! Stop! Leo!
Stop this!
No! No!
Oh,
no. Leo! Stop! Please! Please!
Stop this!
Leo!
Right!
Leo!
Don't just...
Right! Don't play, Leo!
Right! Right! The bouche! Fais mon Chris, que je te tue!
S'il vous plaît, Leo! Look what you did to my car! Nice, Leo! Really nice! guns, explosions? Haven't you people ever heard of lawyers, huh? Huh? We could have both died, Leo. And for what? For an extra little piece of peach? Huh? Huh? Oh my God, where are your values? Your priorities? You know, I am a little disappointed in you. I'm disappointed in you, Leo.
Take the motel. It's yours.
Leo? Leo? Leo! Bring the papers. We got it.
Toi, mon garçon, t'es un des nôtres. You're one of us. Your name is not Lamoury. T'es un Lamoureux.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for George Mihalka.
Thank you so much for something that is so unexpected, but I guess something that I never thought I'd get, but it's one amazing thing. I used to be able to wing this, but now I've got to do it on paper. So if you guys don't mind, I'll just kind of try to read it and see if I can wing it through. I am truly humbled by this experience, humbled to accept this award from my peers, to join the select group of exceptional filmmakers who have preceded me. The Guild has been a very important part of my life, having served as Quebec Vice President and President. Sterla said most of that stuff anyway. But the most cherished award I've ever received was the Distinguished Service Award from the Guild a few years ago. I thought it can't get better than that, and now this. I gotta thank Anil Golubov for talking me into being active in the Guild 25 years ago. And I gotta thank Sterla Gunnarsson and Tim Southam for continuing to make the Guild a welcoming home for filmmakers, for championing Canadian culture, for the inclusiveness and diversity of our organization. I'm honored to have played a small role in making the Guild into the world-class professional community it is now. It's kind of hard to get around my head that this is a Lifetime Achievement Award, you know, because when I don't look in the mirror, I still feel like a cocky young man graduating from film school, ready to tackle any project anywhere at any time. But I guess it has been 40 years since then, and although the road has been dotted with some detours, potholes, black ice, dangerous curves, and tons of construction, it's been a pretty good ride for the first generation kid of refugees who arrived in this wonderful country at the age of 9, not speaking a word of English or French. Not quite true. I knew how to say yes, no, and passport. Slowly my vocabulary increased while my confrontation with bullies decreased. Sterla told you about the fight, so I'll have to get into that. So for years I didn't have much interaction with kids my age. Instead I observed the world around me and buried myself in my parents' eclectic library of masterpieces translated into Hungarian.
That worked out well, and I was able to keep my Hungarian fluent while I polished my French and English pugilistic skills. The rest was easy. A two-year experiment in teaching, first literature at a high school I graduated from, then experimental electronic art at Concordia University, from which I also graduated, and then a chance encounter with John Locke, the head of the cinema department at Concordia. And the rest is, well, the beginning of my journey as a filmmaker. And this is where I need to express my thanks to all the generous and patient mentors, colleagues, and friends who believe that this hot-headed, opinionated young man was worth their time, their advice, and their love. First, but I would like to thank all the wonderful crews from across the country and from around the world without whom no director can ever make a film. From production designers, DOPs, grips and gaffers, ADs, production managers, accountants, drivers, and PAs, thank you all for helping me become worthy of this great honor I'm receiving tonight. I must also thank the visionary producers who gave me the opportunities to make films. Jack Murphy and Bob Presner, who believed that a kid 2 years out of film school was ready for his first feature. John Dunning and Andre Link at Cinepix, who believed that a young director with one comedy film in his arsenal was ready to make a horror film for Paramount with a 1,200 theater release in the works. And 15 years later, gave me the gift to work with Sir Michael Caine and Sir Michael Gambon. Robert Lantos, who gave me my first chance to direct a film in French after I decided that I was a Canadian who wanted to work in Canada. Claude Bonin, Jacques Bonin, Pierre Sarrazin, Suzette Couture, and Robert Lantos, who gave me an opportunity to make La Florida, the first bilingual feature which became a critical and theatrical success in both solitudes. Vincent Gabriel and Jacques Blanc, who trusted me to do showrun and direct the first 19 episodes of Scoop, giving me an opportunity to learn TV production. Robin Spry, André Picard, Francine Allaire, Claude Bonin, Chris Haddock, and André Barrault, and José Vallée, who all gave me opportunities to create award-winning projects from coast to coast and from Cuba to South Africa, stops in Europe, and all the way to Mars. Bill Marks, who gave me an opportunity to reinvent myself when ageism reared its unwelcome head. And Steve Lucas, who showed me that mentorship is as rewarding as creating. And once again, I must thank Robert Lantos, who's given me a brand new opportunity to return full cycle to my birthplace to develop, executive produce, and direct Hungary's biggest ever production, a medieval drama based on the life of János Hunyadi, its greatest statesman and warrior. I gotta thank my agents over the years, whose sage advice and guidance were always astute and welcome. From Laurie Rotenberg, the great pioneer of the industry in Canada, Linda Saint and Sohrab Merchant of the characters. But most important, it's been the people in my personal life, my friends, and those collaborators who turn into friends that I must thank from the bottom of my heart for keeping me grounded and honest through these years of adventure, of highs and lows, as anyone in this business knows only too well. My dear friend for 50 years, Rodney Gibbons, classmate and roommate at university, my business partner for many years and DOP on the majority of my first 10 features. Donna Noonan, designer, and Gabor Vadney, sound engineer, close college friends and continuous collaborators. Steven Zoller, artist and writer extraordinaire. Danielle Jarry, my life and business partner for over 20 years, mother of my precious daughter, whose encouragement and support I will always be grateful for. The light of my life, my daughter Anastasia, whose humor and wisdom keep my feet firmly on the ground. My two wonderful stepkids, Ethan and Veronica, who have reminded me what it's like to be a teenager again. And their mom, Susan Kern, who met me at the darkest moment of my life and whose love and nurturing turned my life around, who taught me that generosity and love does conquer all. And my parents, whose courage in escaping the horrors of totalitarianism with two small suitcases and a desperate desire for freedom have given me this opportunity to live and flourish in a country so welcoming and tolerant. Let's never allow the forces of hate, xenophobia, and misguided nationalism to undermine this great country of ours. Now that I've droned down, in closing, I would just like to say one more thing. Again, I thank the Guild for this great honor, but I'm not yet ready to roam the pastures. So hopefully in about 10 to 15 years from now, maybe you'll consider that I'm ready for another one, because I'm just catching my second wind. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Please join me in welcoming to the stage from Mary Kills People, Abigail Winter, and from The Handmaid's Tale, Nina Curie.
Tonight's nominees in post-production for dramatic series include global hits, international co-productions, and shows that are purely Canadian.
These teams didn't fix it in post. Well, they did sometimes. But they mostly killed it in post.
The nominees for Best Picture Sound Editing Dramatic Series are
Dave Rose, Dashin Naidu, Nelson Ferreira, Craig McClellan, Dustin Harris, The Expanse, IFF, Joe Brachila, Tyler Whitman, Alex Bullock, Jill Purdy, Kevin Banks, Craig McClellan, American Gods, The Beguiling Man, John Loringer, Alistair Gray, Dan Sexton, Scott Donald, Gren Eric Charles Wicker, Into the Badlands, Chapter 32, Seven Strike is One, Mark Beck, Jonas Kuhneman, Richard Calistan, Joseph Doan, Murdoch Mysteries, Sir, Sir, Sir. Joe Brachila, Joe Mancuso, Nadia Hanlon, Danielle McBride, Dashin Naidu, Tyler Whitman, and with an E, Youth is the Season of Hope.
And the winners are?
It's a hard envelope.
It's a hard envelope. Let's see. You want me to? Okay. Yeah, here, hold this. Joe Brachio, Tyler Whitman, Alex Bullock, Jill Purdy, Kevin Banks, and Craig McClellan, American Gods, The Beguiling Man.
Thank you all. I just want to thank the DGC. When I consider the amazing talent we have in this country, this is truly an honor. There's so many great people that work in this industry, and we're doing great things here. I'd like to thank Stars and
Amazon,
thank you. I'd also like to thank this great crew and for all their great work and hard work. Thank our mixers, Joe and Lou, and the rest of the crew at Sim. It was truly a pleasure working with you.
Linda McKenzie.
Of course, Linda. Well, I was going to say, Linda, congratulations on keeping your sanity, I think. Andy Malcolm and Footsteps, the team, for all their great work. And personally, I'd like to thank Nelson Ferreira. If it wasn't for you, Nelson, I wouldn't have this wonderful career that I have. I owe it all to you. I really like to thank you for all you've done for me and my family. You're truly a wonderful person, and I'm better for knowing you. Thank you.
Excited for this one. The nominees for Best Picture Editing Dramatic Series are Wendy Hallam Martin, The Handmaid's Tale, June. Anna Yavari, The Handmaid's Tale, After. Lisa Grutenbauer, Anne with an E, Memory Has as Many Moods as the Temper. Stephen Rogue, The Expanse, Abaddon's Gate. And Thurbin Beher, Pure, Wedding. And the winner is Wendy Hallam Martin, The Handmaid's Tale.
Thanks, guys. Thank you to the DGC for this incredible night and for honoring me. And to my fellow nominees, congratulations. Your work is amazing. It's hard to be singled out like this, but appreciated. Thank you. Just want to thank everybody, cast and crew, Handmaid's Tale, my amazing director, Mike Barker, who directed this episode, to Take Five, the gang, who support all of us in post, and to Sim, who I still call Tattersall, thank you for your incredible sound work, to Deluxe for making the pictures look so beautiful, to everybody behind the scenes, my assistants, our post supervisor, Corey and Catherine and Anna and Lauren and Wes, and to my coworkers, especially Chris Donaldson, who is a partner in crime. And I really appreciate that. And I want to give a special shout out to Stephen Lawrence, who was my mentor, who brought me up through this industry and taught me everything I know. Thank you to my husband, Gary, and family. So thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome President of the Canadian Society of Cinematographers, George Willis, and Director of the upcoming Tammy's Always Dying, Amy Jo Johnson.
The next five nominees created five astonishing worlds of performers to inhabit and directors and cinematographers to commit to film.
The nominees for Best Production Design Dramatic Series are, oh God, look at, I opened the thing. I saw, oh geez, hang on. All right, Mark Steele, The Umbrella Academy, The Day That Wasn't. Elizabeth Williams, The Handmaid's Tale, Seeds. Tamara Deverell, Star Trek Discovery, Such Sweet Sorrow, Part Two. Rory Chain, American Gods, Donor the Great. And Jean-Francois Campeau, and with an E, signs are small, measurable things, but interpretations are, what is that word? Illimitable? Oh, and the winner is, oh my Lord, okay. Tamara Deverell, Star Trek Discovery, Such Sweet Sorrow.
Wow, Star Trek wins something finally. I brought my crew up here, part of them. It's big, so they all voted. That's why I'm here. and I'm totally nervous. I wasn't expecting this. Thanks to the DGC. Thanks to Star Trek for always the cast, the crew, everybody, the creators, for celebrating diversity and inclusion. And I'm here with my team because I don't do this alone, and it's great. Thank you.
So 2019 is only the second year that DGC Awards nominees were selected by live in-person juries assembled from across the country. And jurors say it has been a great experience. This is also the first year that juries were able to add a fifth nominee to their category, if there were exceptional circumstances. However, the jurors for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Dramatic Series were so impressed with their slate of candidates that they insisted on adding a sixth.
The nominees for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Dramatic Series are Matthias Herndahl, The Twilight Zone, Point of Origin. Jeremy Podeswa, The Handmaid's Tale, The Last Ceremony. Deborah Chow, American Gods, Moonen. Adam Kane, Deadly Class, Ciudad. Marzi Almas, Impulse, New Beginnings. Philippe Rodriguez, Blood and Water, Episode 201.
And the winner is?
It's here somewhere. Jeremy Podeswa, The Handmaid's Tale, for me.
The award for Outstanding Directorial Achievement of Dramatic Series is presented by Panavision and accompanied by $10,000 equipment credit.
Thank you. Oh, thank you, thank you.
I'm gonna put this down.
I'm sorry, I need a prop as well. Thank you to everybody. Thank you to everyone in the Directors Guild. I am really honored to be in this room and in this company. And thank you and congratulations to my fellow nominees for doing amazing work. Congratulations to you. Working on Handmaid's Tale is in so many ways an exceptional experience. I really have to acknowledge some of the people who shared the journey with me. I wish you were all up here with me, everyone who's nominated tonight and everybody who isn't even in the room. I could not have done it without you. None of us does it without anybody else, without everybody else. So some of the people I'd like to acknowledge include, first, the amazingly gifted writer Yelin Chang, extraordinary producers and producer and creator Bruce Miller, producer extraordinaire Warren Littlefield, and the ever fabulous Sheila Hawken, to whom I owe so much. And of course, the original gangster, Margaret Atwood. Also, brilliant director of photography Colin Watkinson, equally brilliant editor Chris Donaldson, production designer Elizabeth Williams, and costume designer Anne Crabtree. You guys are all the best of the best of the best. As a director, you could also not be luckier than to work with actors like Elizabeth Moss, Joe Fiennes, Yvonne Strahovski, Alexis Bledel, Max Minghella, and Anne Dowd. Their work brought me to tears in the cutting room many times. Chris can attest to that. I was in awe working with them every day. I also want to say that one of the reasons this show is so meaningful to work on is that it serves as a powerful mirror to the world. This episode, The Last Ceremony, deals with the horrific separation of Offred from her daughter, Hannah. The very week that the show aired, hundreds of children were being brutally separated from their parents along the Mexico-US border. No one involved in the show could ever have imagined that the episode would mirror so closely what was happening in that very moment of its release. But it's an example of the show's importance and brilliance that it so compassionately and with purpose made us look at what was happening around us while moving us and then challenging us to take action. It was a unique gift to be a small part of telling this story. I want to thank everyone involved with the show and thank you tonight. Thank you.
Please welcome back Vice President of the Directors Guild of Canada and DGC Award winner tonight, Norma Bailey.
Thank you. The DGC Honorary Life Member Award is given every year to a non-guild member whose outstanding contribution to the industry has had a major beneficial impact on the Guild and its members, or in the field of film and television as a whole. The National Executive Board selects the recipient of this award. Past recipients have been Alanis Obumsawin, Trina McQueen, Peter O'Brien, and Rob Sim. This year, I am proud to present this award to a dear friend of mine who has worked tirelessly for Manitoba filmmakers for the past 30 years. I met Carol Vivier in 1987 when she began working in administration for the newly formed Cultural Industries Development Office, which became what is now known as Manitoba Film and Music. When we met, she had just started her job in this newly formed government department, and I was a filmmaker who had just returned to Manitoba and was trying to make a television series which would eventually become Daughters of the Country. Both of us were very green, and neither of us really knew where we were headed in our so-called careers. But we discovered that we lived on the same street in the north end of Winnipeg, and that we both loved sewing. And so our friendship began. And we've watched each other grow and mature over the years in this industry. Carol's new job in administration didn't last very long, as within 3 years, she had risen to become CEO of the Cultural Industries Office. Carol is known locally, nationally, and internationally as an ambassador for Manitoba filmmakers. Strategic and entrepreneurial, Carol pioneered the first film tax credit in Western Canada in 1997. But before that tax credit, Carol would go down to LA by herself with an impossible mission to try and convince a bunch of Hollywood executives that Winnipeg, Manitoba, was the place to shoot movies. She had no crews, no tax incentives. It took a full day to get from Winnipeg to California. It still does, Carol. There's still no direct flight. She had no GPS on her rented car, just handwritten notes and maps she printed out. But she had guts and determination. And during her time at Manitoba Film and Music, Manitoba's film production volume grew from $12 million in 1992 to over $210 million in 2019. Carol's tireless efforts have earned her a reputation as an effective and forward-thinking business leader. She's been a champion for independent artists in their earliest efforts, including Guy Madden, The Weaker Thans, Doc Walker, The Crash Test Dummies, Tanya Tagak, and many others. And she's been instrumental in bringing such shows as Capote, The Assassination of Jesse James by the Coward Robert Ford, Channel Zero, Less Than Kind, Burden of Truth, and many others to our province. Manitoba is now a place where Netflix, Amazon, Lionsgate, Warner Brothers, Sony, and Hallmark, and many others return again and again for their productions. For three decades, Carol Vivier has been at the forefront of developing Manitoba's film and television industries into international success stories. And it's because of this passionate championing of our creative industry that we are pleased to make her an honorary life member of the Directors Guild of Canada. Carol?
The Honorary Life Member Award is presented by Bell Media.
I'm so glad Norma and George also use notes, because I can't wing it either. Thank you so much, Norma. I mean, first of all, another round of applause for Norma for winning tonight for Mary Kill's People. I've had the pleasure of witnessing Norma's really impressive career from her beginnings at the NFB to her accolades at the Cannes Film Festival, and now her status as a major television director. I too have the distinct pleasure of calling her my dear friend, and I couldn't imagine a better person to receive this award from tonight. So thank you so much, Norma. And thank you, of course, to the DGC, the board, Stephen, Gary, Kathy, Catherine, and Tim. It's a privilege and an honor to be recognized for my work on behalf of Manitoba's film industry in front of so many people that I truly love and respect. I never would have thought that when I started in the clerical position, as Norma just mentioned, that at Manitoba Film and Music 30 years ago, that one day I'd be standing here in front of you. I'm proud to be from Manitoba, and I'm proud of what Manitoba's film industry has accomplished over the last 20, 30 years. In 97, as Norman mentioned, we had about a $12 million industry, and I'm thrilled to report that we have become now close to a $300 million industry. Thank you. We have a permanent tax credit with a very strong crew base, a wealth of talent, including directors, writers, actors, and producers. It has been a true joy to watch Manitoba's talented directors thrive in the Canadian and international filmmaking landscape. And I'm proud that Manitoba Film and Music supported the success of directors like Norma, Gary Yates, Jonas Chernick, Sheila Carter, Guy Madden, Sean Garrity, Danishka Esterhazy, Deco Dawson, and so many, many more. Now that's a success story I'm delighted to be a part of. We may not have the largest population in the country, but I do think we do punch well above our weight. While I'd love to take all the credits, I can't. No one can, because it truly takes a village to build an industry. Over the past 30 years, I've had the enjoyment of working with the dedicated team at Manitoba Film and Music, talented Manitobans and Canadians, including the unions and guilds, federal and provincial agencies, and industry associations, the NSI, distributors, broadcasters, the CMF, and Telefilm, who all fight for projects and work hard every day to make this sector what it is. There are too many people to thank individually, but you know who you are. Thank you for this opportunity to reflect on my work, which also happens to be my passion. I cannot tell you how grateful I am to retire from a career I love, to spend more time with family and friends, and my husband of 48 years, who's here with me tonight. Can you believe that, 48 years? I will take this award home and share it with the many Manitobans who've worked hard to make Manitoba's production industry what it is. We proved that if you build it, they will come. Well, we built it, Manitoba, and they came, and more importantly, they will stay. Thank you. I will cherish this evening for the rest of my life, and I will continue to be one of your biggest fans. Wish you all the best, and congratulations to all the nominees and the winners tonight. Thank you so much.
Please welcome a filmmaker who has directed television series for Marvel, DC, Netflix, YouTube Premium, and Stars, all in the last year, Mirzi Almas.
Thanks, guys. The DGC Discovery Award honors a bold new voice in Canadian film. And tonight's nominees certainly epitomize new and untold visions. It is an honor and a treat to read these five names out that I know we'll be hearing from in years to come. The nominees for the DGC Discovery Award are Matthew Rankin, The 20th Century, Nicole Dorsey, Black Conflux, Tasha Hubbard, Nipa Wistamasawin, We Will Stand Up. Harry Tipka Raff. And Heather Young, Murmur. And the winner is Tasha Hubbard. Nika Wisdomasa win. We will stand up.
The DGC Discovery Award is presented by Vanguard Artist Management.
Music to accompany me everywhere I go. I want to start by thanking Debbie Baptiste and Jade Tatusis, Colton Baptiste family, or Colton Bushi Baptiste family, for having the bravery and the courage to follow whatever path takes them towards justice. And for being willing to trust me and share their story and their journey with me, and I'm forever honored by that more than anything. I'd like to thank my producers, George Hupka, who is also my longtime DP, who took a chance on, I'm like, let's co-produce for the first time. Also to my NFB producers, John Montez, Bonnie Thompson, and David Christensen, and I want to just acknowledge Bonnie Thompson, who produced my first film. I started working on it in 2000, and then she was very patient with me while I gathered the courage to start making films again a few years ago. I would also like to thank Janice Daw and Kathy Average Johnson from Visible Media. That was a team that was truly the most supportive team that helped me bring all of my efforts to the screen. I also like to thank my editor, Hans Olsen, who edited my last feature and this one, for his love and his gentleness and his talent. And, you know, I say that, you know, so many of the crew brought their love to this film, and that's why I'm here today. Thank you so much.
Please welcome President of MPA Canada, Wendy Noss, and founder of Sinking Ship, J.J. Johnson.
Tonight's nominees for Best Sound Editing Feature Film include everything from a horror movie produced by Guillermo del Toro
to something truly scary, a movie about Rob Ford's worst moment as mayor of Toronto. As if there was just one.
The nominees for Best Sound Editing Feature Film are J.R. Fountain, Jill Purdy, Steve Medeiros, Tyler Whittem, Claudia Pinto, Kevin Banks for Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. Nelson Ferreira, J.R. Fountain, Dasha Naidu, Rose Gregoris, Dustin Harris for Run This Town. Alan Geldart, Emily Busick for The Rest of Us. Brent Pickett, Kristen Hunter, Paul German, Christopher Alan King for Goalie. Fred Brennan, Kevin Banks, Mark Shinersky, Dave Johnson for Through Black Spruce.
And the winners are J.R. Fountain, Jill Purdy, Steve Mentos, Tyler, Claudia, and Kevin. Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark.
Thank you so much to the DGC. Really proud to be up here for this film. Thank you to Andre Overdell, our director, to Patrick Larsgaard, our picture editor, our producers, Miles Dale, Guillermo del Toro, Sean Daniel, and there's a few others, but there was a lot of producers on this film. Doug Wilkinson, amazing post supervisor. Thank you.
that was really good. Also, like to thank our mixers, Andrew Tay, Mike Warnick, Scott Hitchin from Technicolor. Technicolor, Doug Wilkinson, another shout out for him. Love you, Doug.
Don't forget Steve Hammond.
Steve Hammond, Foley, amazing.
And
I think that's it.
I think that's it. Thanks so much. Thanks to the DGC.
Our final post-production category of the night, Best Picture Editing Feature Film.
The nominees are Simone Smith, Firecrackers. Laura Johnston for Mouthpiece. Cam McLaughlin for Clifton Hill. Susan Shipton for Guest of Honor. And Charles Ross for Hero.
And the winner is Laura Johnston for Mouthpiece.
Thank you. Thanks to the DGC. I have to say this film was so much fun to edit, and I have to especially thank one person, Patricia Rosimoff, for, I'm sure, what was a leap of faith to hire me. So thank you. She's in every frame of this film. I want to thank the other people that made my job so wonderful. Catherine Lutz, who I think is in the room, cinematographer. Zazu, production designer, Amy and Nora, who did the play, which this was based on, which was amazing, and then wrote a movie with Patricia that was just equally as weird. The assistant editors, Joel and Anna, the sound people who are here, Paul, Brennan, Kathy, Matt, Graham, I'm missing some people. And finally, my beautiful family, Pete, my husband, who always has my back, and my girls, Allie and Sadie, who light up every day for me. So thank you very much.
Please join me in welcoming Director X to the DGC stage.
Epic music. I was hoping I was going to get that Bruno Mars record for the come out, you know. Pick up everyone in the room. It's really exciting to be here. Say, with the production levels really come up. Can we give a hand to, you know? Last time I was at the awards, it was definitely wasn't the funky award show stage. So we are going to honor four exceptional artists whose designs, whose worlds, whose creativity graced the silver screen this year. The nominees for Best Production Design Feature Film are Emmanuel Frechetta, The Hummingbird Project. Philip Barker, Guest of Honor. Philip came deep, I see. Chris Kane, Clifton Hill. Go on with it. All right. Taya Holatz, Firecrackers. And the winner is Emmanuel Frechetta, The Hummingbird Project. Oh, my goodness. Should have kept reading. Unfortunately, Emmanuel couldn't be with us this evening. I will be accepting the award on his behalf. Sure. All right, where's my other cards coming? All right, the last award to the night, let's get it. The nominees for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Feature Film are Robert Boudreau, Stockholm. Zach Lipofsky, co-directed with Adam Stein, Freaks. Patricia Rose Emma, Mouthpiece. Yasmin Mozafari, Firecrackers. And Mary Clements, Red Snow. And there's a twist. We have a tie. So here's how we're going to do this. We're going to... The first winner for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Feature Film is... Patricia Rosema and Team Mouthpiece.
The award for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in Feature Film is presented by Technicolor, lead sponsor of the DGC Awards Gala. The award is accompanied by $2,500 in production credit.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I've never had such a thing. Thanks to my co-producers, Christina Piovizan and Jennifer Shin, Telefilm, Breaking Barriers, Ontario Creates, and new for me, I went to some people of means and who liked the arts, and I said, do you have any money? This is the worst investment you'll ever make, but anyway, and several people actually stepped forward. I won't tell you their last names because then they'll be inundated, but Martha and the other Martha and I should remember, Alex and Angela, Kate, and I want to thank Lara Johnston. I'm so happy you won, my editor, my clear-eyed, clear-minded editor. Zazu Myers production designer, Catherine Lutz. Where are you, Catherine? You're like up for every third film in this. This whole the evening. She's an astounding cinematographer. Mostly I want to thank Amy Nostbakken and Nora Sadova for their play, and then also for their sense of enormous sense of play when we wrote the screenplay together and made this crazy film together. And I am exceptionally thankful that I live in this country and that boldness is rewarded. So thank you. And who else? Who's the other one? Who's this? Thank you.
And once again, the winner for Outstanding Directorial Achievement in a Feature Film is Robert Boudreau and Team Stockholm.
I'd like to thank the DGC, of course. I'd like to thank my lovely, lovely wife, Rebecca Snow. Obviously, directing is I think, one of the most collaborative of all arts, and so I'd like to thank, firstly, my cast on this, Ethan Hawke, Noomi Rapace, Christopher Heyerdahl, Bea Santos, who's here, I think, tonight. I'd like to thank my producers, Nicholas Tabarak, Jonathan Bronfman. I'd like to thank my my wonderful first AD, Dan Murphy, who's always there for me on the team. I love Dan. I'd like to thank my DOP, Brendan Stacey, my production designer, Aidan LaRue, my composer, Steve London, and everybody really on the crew, because I feel, in so many ways, the director is really only as good as who he surrounds himself with. So. Thanks again to everybody. Thank you.
Friends, once again, Amal.
Thank you. So I take it you guys have had a little bit to drink, so just join me in this and, you know, have some fun. Okay.
dance with you. What a waste of time. It's spent up way, that's all you do. You've been making nickels off my dime. And so what, I loved you. And so what, I tried. I gave you everything, and now my love is running dry. I'm sorry to say this, I don't wanna save it. I just wanna fly away. I feel like you miss it, the days I would visit, and you did your time, but I pay. All this time you've been quiet, and now you're outspoken. And what I learned about fixing love, you can't fix what's broken. No, yeah. And so what, I loved you. And so what, I tried. I gave you everything, and now my love is running dry. I'm sorry to say this, I don't wanna save it. I just wanna fly away. I feel like you miss it, the days I would visit. You did your time, but I pay. Don't take it personal, it's just the way it goes. Don't take it, don't take it. Yeah, no, 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 no. Don't take it personal, it's just the way it goes. Don't take it, no, yeah. I'm sorry to say this, I don't wanna save it. I just wanna fly away. I feel like you miss it, the days I would visit. And you did your time, but I paid. Sorry, I'm so sorry, baby. Sorry, baby, yeah. Sorry, baby, oh, I'm so sorry.
Thank you, guys. Take care. Thank you so much. Oh, and this is TJ, by the way. He's incredible. Have to give it to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been the 2019 DGC Awards Gala.